text and handwriting and voice and so on. You want to put it all together, and you want to be able to interact with a person. One of the ways that you can do that is with a bot. And the bot framework is something that we have that allows you to have a natural language interface across lots of different communication channels. And I'll show you some of those in just a moment. You can provide information to your users. You can do things based on what they tell you. You can go out and maybe order a pizza or whatever they happen to need in this case. You can make recommendations. I see you're doing this. Maybe you want to do that. And you can also record the interactions later to derive patterns and so on. And you could do that by feeding it into yet another artificial intelligence construct. In fact, let's go take a look at one. I've created a very simple bot here. Let me turn off the picture of Buck there. I think we're done with him. I've created a bot. I called it BuckBot. And, of course, you would deploy this to various locations. I'll show you that in a moment. But I've just opened the test in web chat here. So this is one channel is web chat. So I'm going to say, hello, BuckBot, comma, I would like a sandwich. It's near noon here in Florida, and I'm a little hungry, so I'd like it to get me a sandwich. And so the bot receives that information, and then it sends it as soon as it gets done here on my little VM that's taking its time to spin. And it'll come back after it's developed the intent. And it said, what kind of sandwich would you like, Buck? And it says, please select a sandwich. Well, I think I'd like to go with a spicy Italian. I'll go with a spicy Italian today. So this is called a card. So rather than taking text or voice, it allowed me to work with a card. Now it's telling me which length you would like to have. And I'm really hungry, so let's go with a foot long today. And so I selected that. Based on what I've chosen so far, it presents me some choices for bread. I say, you know, I like Italian. But this was sort of ambiguous. You can see here we've got Italian and Italian herbs and cheese, right? So we've got two Italians, and it says, which one did you mean? So it was actually able to realize that my intent may not have been clear. And so it allowed, and I've decided I think I want the herbs and cheese. You could just never have too much cheese, I think. In fact, we get to select a cheese now based on that, so I'll just do pepper jack. I think you get the idea here. Now, we've switched over from cards to working with a selection that I can use, and I like spicy things, so we'll go with jalapenos there, and we need a sauce, and so let's do, sweet onion, I think I like. Let's do that. And so then what it will do, the bot will return to me, is this what you were looking for? So it's actually been tracking everything. Now, something else the bot can do is it can take in other interfaces. So I could have programmed into the bot to take in voice, as in talking, or even sending a picture. And then what I could have done is run that through the Cognitive Vision API to scrub for a certain tag. And I could have shown it pictures of my bicycle, and it maybe will scrub that to see with the custom service, is this under warranty or not? And it would say, well, we do think that's under warranty. Can you give us your address, and we'll send someone to you? So that's the way that could work. So it says, is this what you want? And I'll say, yes, that looks pretty good. And so then what it would do here, this was a form bot is what I created. So this is the end of it. And here I would say, okay, great. Let's get your credit card information and so on. Now, this was done showing you just doing this inside a web browser, but you can actually, this has got code behind it. So using an SDK and so on, you can actually work with the code. And in fact, right inside the portal here, there's a code editor, and I've just popped that up here. You can see, and I can actually work with the code right inside this interface as well, and then redeploy it. Speaking of deployment, where would I put it? Well, once you've developed your code, and again, you could do that on the web, or you can do it inside Visual Studio or that sort of thing, you select the container it will go to. So by default, you've got the web interface here, but I could say, well, I'd actually like that to go inside a Microsoft Teams connector card, and we have interfaces to all kinds of things, Skype, Slack channels, and so on, but I'm going to pop this one into Teams connector card. This one says, how's my flight doing, and it comes back with the word delayed there and shows me that going with Sarah, Jeremy, and Evan that I'm going to be in trouble I've got a delay, which is pretty common these days. And I can also do a toast. Now, a toast is a pop-up inside Windows so that you can pop up a thing saying, hey, did you realize you're going to be late? And then perhaps your bot could say, would you like me to reschedule your hotel? And so on. By stringing all of these AI components together, you can create a very complete solution. And I could also send this out to a Skype card. You're actually able to integrate the bot, and you could call it on Skype, and you end up interacting and talking with a bot that can show you all kinds of things, in this case a card. And I could also put this, of course, in a live tile inside Windows. The idea here is I can deploy it multiple times using the exact same code. I don't have to change my code in any way. Setting the container will handle the sizing and framing and the way it interacts with the user. We do this with the Bot Builder, it's called, and there's an open source SDK you can get, and that's actually on GitHub. You can fork that or download it or clone it if you wish, or just use it. And it automatically comes with Node.js support, of course the .NET languages, and then really anything that can call REST can work with it as well. And I designed what you saw earlier just using a simple form flow default diagram. Very easy to do, very, very quick to create that. And again, you can use images, you can use videos, you could send a Word document, it can read that, and so on. As you're developing, we've got an emulator for you which will run in the Windows environment so that you can simulate the bot running as a service without actually deploying it yet. And then you can also add other cognitive services, such as maybe Lewis, which is the language understanding and integration. And with Lewis, what you can do is define out, okay, people will ask me a question like this that has these kinds of direct objects and these subjects and so on. And then it will allow people to talk in the way that they normally converse, and it will handle the complexities of language for you. And, of course, then you could stack on top of that the translator API and allow your bot to be multilingual, such that if somebody responded in a certain language, let's say Spanish, Espanol, it would automatically return in Espanol to that person. There's a full developer portal, and I think you saw some of that there, but there's a you're able to register and publish your bots. And that can go into a directory, if you wish, that your company or organization or customers or the general public can use, that you can talk directly to those and find and locate the bots. So that's the part you can do there. So hopefully that little demo gave you an idea. There's full sets of code, by the way, and we've got lots and lots of examples of this. And again, I'm going to give you a couple links here at the end that'll get you through some training.